Welcome to Choral Evensong here at Chester Cathedral, whether you're with us in the choir or joining us online. Today the Church gives thanks for the life and ministry of Richard, Bishop of Chichester, who became Bishop of Chichester in 1245 and defended the Church against the King. An excellent model of a diocesan bishop, accessible, generous and fair. So we sing the hymn 221. The congregation is invited to be seated while the choir sings Psalms 82 to 85, standing for the Gloria.
Thank you. First lesson is written in Genesis chapter 47, beginning to read at verse 1. So Joseph went and told Pharaoh, "My father and my brothers, with their flocks and herds, and all they possess, have come from the land of Canaan. They are now in the land of Goshen." From among his brothers he took five men and presented them to Pharaoh. Pharaoh said to his brothers, "What is your occupation?" And they said to Pharaoh, "Your servants are shepherds, as our ancestors were." They said to Pharaoh, "We have come to reside as aliens in the land, for there is no pasture for your servants' flocks, because the famine is severe in the land of Canaan. Now we ask you, let your servants settle in the land of Goshen." Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Your father and your brothers have come to you. The land of Egypt is before you. Settle your father and your brothers in the best part of the land. Let them live in the land of Goshen. And if you know that there are capable men among them, put them in charge of my livestock." Then Joseph brought in his father Jacob and presented him before Pharaoh. And Jacob blessed Pharaoh. Pharaoh said to Jacob, "How many are the years of your life?" Joseph said to Pharaoh, "The years of my earthly sojourn are 130. Few and hard have been the years of my life. They do not compare with the years of the life of my ancestors during their long sojourn." Then Jacob blessed Pharaoh and went out from the presence of Pharaoh. Joseph settled his father and his brothers and granted them a holding in the land of Egypt, in the best part of the land, in the land of Ramesses, as Pharaoh had instructed. And Joseph provided his father, his brothers, and all his father's household with food, according to the number of their dependents. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
The second lesson is written in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, beginning to read at verse 12. But we appeal to you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who labor among you and have charge of you in the Lord and admonish you. Esteem them very highly in love because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves, and we urge you, beloved, to admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak, be patient with all of them. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. Do not despise the words of prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Beloved, pray for us. Greet all the brothers and sisters with a holy kiss. I solemnly command you by the Lord that this letter be read to all of them. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Thank you. the choir sing the anthem, A Prayer, by the 20th century composer Richard Lloyd. Let us pray. We begin with the famous prayer of Richard of Chichester, used widely in the centuries since his death. Thanks be to thee, my Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits thou hast given me, for all the pains and insults which thou hast borne for me. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know thee more dearly and follow thee more nearly, day by day. Amen. We pray for those who continue to lead the church today. For Mark, Julie, and Sam, the bishops of this diocese. Within the diocese, for the parish of Bunbury, for their clergy, Tim and Claire, and lay workers Kathy, Peter, Tom, Pat, Amber, Joy, and Nicholas. We pray for the Anglican Communion, particularly for those places where Christians face persecution and marginalization. Praying today for the Diocese of Tirunelveli in South India. We pray for the Church's work with communities affected by climate change and illegal logging in Melanesia. Praying for a better stewardship of the earth. For wisdom and discernment for the leaders of the nations. For our own government. And for all those involved in power, all those exercising power and influence in society. We give thanks for the life of our city and county and pray for all who have visited this place today, for our staff and volunteers, especially this evening for Jessica Stonia and Kate Luff. As the mystery place set continues to be built around us, we pray that we may continue to encounter the mystery and wonder of God in this place. We bring to God also those we carry on our hearts today, those in a special need, for those known to us personally and those in the news. Continuing to pray especially for those affected by the tragic events in Nottingham this week. For places of conflict, particularly for the peoples of Ukraine. For all refugees and migrants. For those missing and drowned in the Sea of Greece. And here in this place, we also name particularly Denise and Mike G and Sarah Mears. And pray for all those who have gone before us in the faith and those who mourn their loss. Remembering especially Brother Leo and Brother Spencer, Nora Skerr, Richard Sugg, Margaret Sumner, and Becky Hay. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. We bring all our prayers together, saying, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.